Look at that, folks. Look at that sunset on that sea. Ain't that something? With the Purbex over there in the distance. Let me see if I can get a bit of zoom on this and give it a bit more. Better frame for the... It's not a full zoom, but there's a bit of zoom there. Okay, I'll capture the talking. I'm going to shut up because I want to see.
I need a key as well.
I don't have one, but I can. Well, evening time now. It's got to be about 7 o'clock, I would think. Dark at about 7:30. So I don't know whether I'll be down here again, if ever. Who knows? This could be my very last time. But, oh, they've just turned the lights on that ship out there. I was wondering when they were going to... Yeah, that's definitely a cruise ship. That white one, you can see the lights on it now. Let me just see if I can expand this a bit so I can get zoomed right in. Zoom right in. I don't know whether you can actually see the lights on there through this. There's four ships anchored out there at the moment. There's the two together, this one on its own, and there's a smaller one, like a coaster or something, which is just to the right of it. It's just coming into the center of the screen now, the coaster. Yeah, there's the coaster. They're about, 2.5-3 miles off shore. Well, you can tell. Got the breakers coming in on the sand down below the cliff, which is where I am now. Let me just get this back to the sort of normal. That's better. There you go. So, sorry about the movement. It's on a tripod, but it's a bit awkward holding it. So yeah, I would say they were about 3 miles off. Now apparently I checked with somebody and the weather's not going to be that bad. What is it? About 6 knots, 7 knots of wind. So that is no reason to park up close inshore like these three have. So I don't know. Perhaps there is something unpleasant weather-wise coming. I don't know. I don't know why they would be there otherwise. But they're there for the night by the look of it. But who knows what their schedules are. Okay, we're kind of looking west now. Tours, but the sun will be disappearing soon. Over the Purbeck, there, what a beautiful range of hills they are. They are gorgeous hills. My kind of country. The thing I most love about this county, those hills. I've zoomed out a little bit. I'm sorry there's a bit of shake, but it's unavoidable with a handheld. So I've just ranged around once more. The beautiful salmon pink colour is gone now. The sun's gone far enough away to just turn everything kind of a light grey colour. So we're looking along the supposed horizon. It's not the real horizon, of course, because as soon as you get out to where that is, it goes on more. So there's no actual physical horizon as such. There's an apparent horizon. We can see the end of the Isle of Wight, which is where the camera's focused now. Kind of center of screen is the what they call the polar bear on it. It looks like a polar bear in a certain position. If you go along towards Bournemouth and then look out at it in sunlight, it looks like the shape of a polar bear, which is really weird, but it does. But that is where the needles are. And that is also where the lighthouse is. That should be actually flashing away soon. You should see it. It's an occultic... hang on, I saw one then. I don't know, that wasn't the needles, that was too far out. I don't know what light that is. You can probably see a flash. That is not the needles light. I don't know which one that is. So there is another one around that way. I can't remember the name of it, but that's not it. That's not the needle's light anyway. The needle's light is an occulting light, and it's right on the needles, which is off the end of that polar bear thingy. There's also a mast, a radio mast, which has got red lights on it, quite a tall one. You probably won't be able to make them out on here, but there is one. I expect they'd be having tea or dinner or whatever you have on these ships at this time of the day. It looks like it. It's all lit up like a Christmas tree anyway, so. I don't know when that light, that actual light comes on. It doesn't appear to be on at the moment, and it should be. But that mid-screen about center of the screen, horizontally, that is the end of the Isle of Wight, the physical end of it, which is known as the Needles. Now, I've got a relative who lives on the Isle of Wight, but he lives right the other end, the Portsmouth end, so you obviously wouldn't see that from here. That's Ryde, the town of Ryde, which is R-Y-D-E, Ryde, and that's right up on the eastern end of the Isle of Wight. It's a shame you didn't live this end. It would have been so much easier to pop across and see him. You couldn't even see you could probably see the ferries going to and fro with a decent set of binoculars, but as I haven't got them, this can't be done. Not even on a full magnification with this thing. It's just not the right instrument to do it with. But anyway, that, my friends, is the Isle of Wight at night. Well, just about at night anyway. There's a little bit of light left, but it's not brilliant. Oh, that coaster's turned his riding lights on, his navigation lights on. It could be a fishing vessel. He might have turned his netting lights on. I don't know. There you are. That's where it is. Center of screen. Horizontally centered. Halfway down between the sky and the sea. And the other vessel, whatever that is to the left of it. One more look at these cruise ships before I disappear from here. I can hear grasshoppers or crickets too, which isn't surprising. So that's a cruise ship, whatever they are, and why ever they're there, who knows. Okay, that's it from me, from here. Get back and edit this, I suppose. Well, thanks for joining me today.